Let's welcome Yi Hong.
Okay. Hello, everyone. I'm Yi Hong Xu from Amit Technology. Firstly, I would like to thank ETH Taipei for organizing this conference and give me an opportunity to speak. To me, my topic is a hierarchical deterministic wallet without seed. Traditional hierarchical deterministic wallet only used seed to generate all required key. But since the seed is stored on a single hardware device, there is a risk of single point of failure. However, today, the wallet I'm introducing is designed based on a HD wallet, but it does not have a seed, which avoids the issue of single point of failure. Sorry for the setting. Sorry for a second. Wait a second. Okay. Let's begin. Key management has always been an important issue in blockchain industry. Unlike traditional financial institution, where lost password or credit card can be retrieved by an identity verification. If an e-wallet private key is stolen, all assets will be gone and cannot be recovered. Over the past decade, exchange or user have suffered financial loss due to the loss or hack or private key. Storage and management of private key become increasingly crucial. Before we introduce HD wallet, let's first talk about a later type of wallet called just a bunch of key. The concept of just a bunch of key is very simple. Each address corresponds to a unique private key. For example, a private key is generated to correspond with address 1. If you want to use second address, a new private key must be generated to correspond with address 2. And this process can be repeated. Each private key is randomly generated and has no correlation with others. Following the principle of changing address for each transaction, a new private key must be generated for every transaction. As a result, just a bunch of key need to store many private keys, making it challenging to store or backup the wallet. HD wallet were later developed to address this issue. The concept of HD wallet is based on Bitcoin Improvement Proposal, or BIP32. The feature of HD wallet is use a single seat to management multiple addresses, making it easier to manage or backup. HD wallet technology has been adopted by many wallet companies, such as IMToken, FreeWallet, MetaMask, and Ledger. However, the just a bunch of key is no longer commonly used. Okay, let's recap the process of HD wallet. You can see that it only use a single seed to generate all private key. And the master key is generated from master key generation, and the child key can be generated from master key through child key derivation. Multiple use of CKD can generate multiple child key. For example, child key 01 to child key 0i. You can again use CKD with input of child key 01, and you can generate the child key of next layer. For example, child key 011. BIP44 defines the meaning of different layers of child key. It is easy to see that managing this random seed is crucial, because if a random seed is stored on a hardware device, such as a computer or a cell phone, if the random seed is hacked or stolen, then all assets stored in the least private key will be stolen. So overcoming the single point of failure will greatly enhance the security of HD wallet. In order to address the issue of single point of failure, the first solution come to mind is to distribute the secret and perform joint computation when needed. This cryptography technique is called multi-party computation, or MPC. For example, there are three parties. They have their own secret input, X1, X2, and X3. They want to jointly compute the function f with X1, X2, X3 as input. But they don't want to reveal their secret input, Xi. The motivation of MPC is to solve this problem. Cryptography ensures that the value of Xi are not be revealed during the MPC. Only a pre-agreed function f, the output is learned. That is, after during MPC, P1 only learns the value F1, X1, X2, X3. P2 only learns F2, and P3 only learns F3. One type of MPC wallet is called threshold signature wallet. Let's recall its process. When generating a new address, each party independently produces the private key share. Note that these are not complete private key, it's just a share of private key. Then use MPC to generate the public key and the address. MPC ensures the complete private key will not be revealed during the key chain process. It is easy to imagine that when multiple transactions occur, you need many of address, and you need to store many private key share, much like just a bunch of key. When performing a signature, three parties use MPC to generate the signature, which is equivalent to sign the transaction using a complete private key. This is emphasized again that the private key will not be reconstructed during this process. Many wallet companies such as Amis, Zengo, BitGo, and Binance are adopting TSS, and Amis and Zengo provide mobile wallet apps, and QB Wallet is a product provided by Amis Technology. It's good to use. You can give it a try. TSS is a hard research field in recent years with many research achievements. Okay, let's see another way to avoid single point of failure. It is multi-signature wallet. Unlike a regular wallet, multiple signature wallet, each party holds a complete private key. So these three key is complete private key, not just a share. These key are bound to a single address with the smart contract or a similar method. When a transaction needs to be made, each party will individually sign the transaction using digital signature. The transaction will only be approved once enough the valid transaction be collected. The verification of transaction is performed on the blockchain. So it is important to know that because multi-signature wallet do not follow the original design of blockchain, they require additional blockchain fee. We will now compare the three types of wallet. The advantage of HD wallet is it manages multiple addresses using only one seed. The TSS wallet and the multi-signature wallet achieving decentralization. But however, the multi-signature wallet has a disadvantage of higher transaction fee. In addition, TSS wallet offer free key rotation and a free dynamic management. Free key rotation means that the TSS allows user to update their share using a reshare protocol. If an adversary cannot steal the threshold number of shares, performing the reshare protocol will render the adversary's old share invalid. Free dynamic management means that the ability to dynamically manage user by allowing the member to be added or removed. But the member information of the multi-signature wallet is set on the blockchain, so key rotation and the dynamic management needs payment. Based on the comparison above, we lean towards using TSS for decentralized wallets. It is evident that TSS has advantages such as decentralization and the flexible key management. But the TSS wallet is difficult to manage multiple addresses. On the other hand, HD wallet only use a seed to manage multiple private key. It is effortless to back up or import the wallet. But they are vulnerable to single point of failure. We need to find a balance between the two wallets. So here is a question. Is it feasible to have a wallet that combines decentralized management with minimal storage requirements? We can see from this picture, the earliest type of wallet is just a bunch of keys. And TSS wallet using MPC technology to solve the issue of single point of failure. From another perspective, the layer structure of HD wallet only used with a seed to store multiple private key. How can we combine the advantage of these two approaches? One solution is to apply MPC technology to the HD wallet, which we called two-party HD wallet. Combining the advantage of TSS wallet and the HD wallet. AMI technology has proposed a two-party computation solution and has been rigorously proven and documented in our research paper, as well as implemented. Our PR is public available at the following link, Get AMI's Alice. In addition to implement the two-party HD wallet, the TSS also be implemented in our Alice with two protocols for ECDSA and one protocol for EDDSA. And our TSS implementation has undergone an audit. It is available for community to use or reference. Apart from our proposal, another company called Unbounded Security has also proposed a two-party HD wallet implementation method. Okay, next, let me introduce our two-party HD wallet, which achieves decentralization and effortless management. Imagine a wallet company and a user that jointly hold a two-party HD wallet and separately store the private key share in different hardware. Suppose they need to store Bitcoin in address one. They perform two-party computation to calculate BIP32 to generate the private share of address one. The private share of address 2 and the private share of address 3 can be generated in the same way. This management approach has a benefit that users do not worry about their funds being misused by the company, as they hold one share themselves. Secondly, the company have better security awareness than a user, reducing the risk of share phishing. Of course, this is only one way to use the two-party HD wallet. It is also possible to keep the share on two separate devices owned by the user or two separate devices owned by the company. Two-party HD wallet have another significant advantage. The private share generated by two-party HD wallet are compatible with the threshold signature. This means that when they need to use Bitcoin to purchase goods, they can directly use threshold signature. In recent years, there have been many research achievements in TSS. Two-party HD wallet can be integrated very well with layer side protocol. Okay, in practice, what share do two-party HD wallet need to store? Following the BIP44, the first four derivations are hardened derivation, and the last two derivations are non-hardened derivation. hardened derivation need to use two-party computation. When frequently used non-hardened key derivation can only locally calculate. Therefore, we suggest to suggest the store the share of previous layer of non-hardened key derivation. Since the hardened key derivation use two-party computation, so they are slowly than non-hardened key derivation. Store this share can save time for child key derivation. According to BIP 44, the address update for each transaction is derived from non-hardened key derivation. As a result, two-party HD wallet need to store significantly fewer shares compared to TSS. Okay, let's recap the process of master key generation. The random seed is feeding in the HashMAC SHA-5 and compute the digest. The left digest IL is master private key. The right digest IR is master transcode. Only the private key is private, and master transcode and master public key are public value. So let's introduce the concept of two-party NKG. Just like classical NKG, but the seed is separate to generated by two different parties, seed 1 and seed 2. They use two-party NKG to obtain this output. The output of two-party NKG is identical to classical NKG, but the private key is split into two parts, master private key 1 and the master private key 2. The master private key 1 only known by P1, and the master private key 2 only known by P2. The coordinates ensures that master private key plus master private key 1 plus master private key 2 is equal to NKG with seed 1 and seed 2 as input. The situation with two-party CKD are similar. They improve the all required input into two-party CKD and obtain this output. And it is the two outputs, the private key is split into two parts, child private key 1 and child private key 2. These two parts can be directly used in TSS. Furthermore, when these two shares can be also applied to TSS reshare protocol. So key rotation on two-party HD wallet is okay. If there is an implementation of multiple CKD in the future, it can also achieve dynamic management. Okay, this is our implementation result. The average time of two-party NKG is about 7 seconds, and the average time of two-party CKD is about two seconds. We need to know that we only need to derive the hardened key only once, so the slightly longer computation time is acceptable. Our implementation is a proof of concept and has not yet undergone an audit. We will continue to improve our program and algorithm in the future. Welcome again to visit our Alice. If you are interested in detail of two-party HD wallet, and feel free to contact us. Thank you for listening to today's presentation.
Thank you, Yihong, for this great talk. So, yeah, does anyone have a question?
So you just talked about like the hardened key. Would you mind like elaborate on that a little bit more? The hardened key, yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
This page.
So can you speak slightly slow down?
Yeah. Like, would you please like elaborate more about like this slide?
Oh. Okay. Yeah. In this slide in the detail.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. The BIP 32 is the derivation of to manage multiple layer of child key. And the BIP 44 defines the each layer meaning of each layer of the BIP 32. For example, BIP 44 defines the first one is master key. Master key use the child key derivation to the first layer of child key. The first layer of child key is index 44, means this is BIP 44. And you can use child key derivation again to generate the next layer of child key. And this layer of child keys means the coin type of the you any like just like Bitcoin or Ethereum, they have different index. You can manage the coin type of the this layer. And suppose you use Bitcoin as index one, and you can derive the Bitcoin child key, use CKD again to derive the account. This next layer is the child key for the account. Suppose you using Bitcoin, you can derive the child key for next layer to Bitcoin account one, Bitcoin account two, and the derivation of the account layer is hardened key derivation. So you have a account, but you want to transaction. You want to transaction every time you want to change your address. Then you BIP 44 defines the address using update every time using the non-hardened key derivation. So there is a BIP 44 talking about the coin type, the account, the address. So the address is from the non-hardened key derivation. And the difference between hardened key and non-hardened key derivation is that the input of HMAC is public key or private key. Hardened key derivation, the input is the private key. But the non-hardened derivation, the input is public key. Thank you.
Any other question? Okay, thanks for Yihong.
Thank you.